Hello everyone, I thought it was fun to film in my living room for my Q&A, so I thought I'd do that again. It's another little corner that we have, our little reading nook that we never use. But today I thought I'd do another tag video that I've seen go around on YouTube. It's called the Starving Artist Tag, and I wouldn't consider myself a starving artist, but I'm not like rolling in money, obviously. So let's get started with the questions. First one is, what's your favorite experience as an artist? I think just being able to make my own art, sell it, that being my full-time job, I think that's pretty ridiculous and amazing. I get to spend all day drawing pretty pictures. It's my hobby, and I get to call that my job. So I think that's the best experience. I love working at home, from home, and I love being so free to with my time and schedule. I can't imagine going back to a 9-to-5 job. My least favorite experience? It is a bummer that I constantly have to like undervalue my work to get paid something. I don't understand why people don't value art and won't pay you for something that you're spending time drawing. They'll spend $500 on a new sweater without blinking sometimes, and they won't pay you for a beautiful illustration that you plan on using for your business for years to come. So, makes no sense to me. What are my dreams and goals as an artist? Well, my biggest dream is just to continue working as a full-time artist. I hope that it doesn't like plummet or disappear one day, and then I can just continue to work as a full-time artist. And I would love to work on tons of different projects. I would love to design, illustrate packaging for a cosmetics company. I think that would be really, really cool. And a clothing company would be awesome, or bedding, pretty much anything. I just want to draw as much as I can. What's my favorite medium and why? I think I finally have found my favorite medium, which is ink drawings on paper. It's so simple, and it's so pretty, and I love the digital element of coloring it in on the computer. And it just makes my work so simple, and it's not messy, and it's so easy. I don't have the pressure to, if I mess up, then I can always delete or erase things in the computer or on the paper. So it's really great. What inspired you to become an artist, and why do you love it? Not really sure. It's art's kind of a thing in my family, on my dad's side. My great aunt is a pretty good artist. She didn't work as an artist, but she was her hobby, and she painted pet portraits, and they're beautiful. My grandmother also was a hobby painter, and she painted beautiful watercolor illustrations of geishas and things. I think she copied lots of old paintings, but still they were beautiful. I love her work. So it's always been something that my family has appreciated. So in school I did lots of art classes, and it was of course the best class, my best class. So I just continued. I haven't really thought about it. It was something I was good at, so I just continued doing it. Oh, why do I love it? It's because I am good at it, so then it becomes fun when you're good at something. You know, simple as that. 6, what's my favorite piece? I think my favorite piece is my Chanel number 5, the first illustration that I did for Emma Christina, because it is so classic and iconic and simple, and I just drew it kind of on a pretty shitty piece of paper, and I wasn't really thinking that it was going to become this business that I've built up. So that's really exciting, and I'm very proud of it. Who are my biggest influences? I feel like I don't really have any huge artists that I really aspire. I really just love all these other artists who are just like me, just trying to live off their art, work from home, maybe a new mommy. I can't think of anyone right now, but I'll post some people in the description box that I think you should go check out on the internet. What have you learned from being a full-time artist? I have learned tons of stuff. I've learned things about being my own boss and having to motivate myself to do work, to find projects, to find clients, to keep deadlines, to organize my finances, to budget and all that stuff, to decide what is a good project, what's not, how to, all that stuff. And just like, and it's trial and error. You just have to try different things, mess up a million times to figure out what to do later on, unfortunately. I'm sure a business course would have been good, but I've learned the hard way and the long way, and that's worked out as well. Now there's so many resources online. I wish I had all this stuff when I had started 7 years ago. So there's plenty of resources now and stuff that I can learn, so I'm definitely still learning. What do friends and family think? I think my family is proud of me now, and they think that I, of course, deserve way more than admiration or success or whatever than I have at the moment, because, you know, I'm their daughter and they think I should be like a illustrator superstar. And my friends, I think they're just kind of nobody. I don't have very many creative friends, so they're kind of like, what do you do all day? How do you, they don't know, they're like, does not compute. But it's the same thing back to them when they tell me what their job is. Like, some friends, they told me what their job is like 5 times, and I still don't get like what they do. They're just a little bit different. Was becoming an artist your childhood dream? Maybe. I think when I was really little, I wanted to be a ballet dancer, so it's kind of an artist as well. And then when I was drawing, I always thought that I would be, but I always also thought that I had to get a real job one day, but I've never really figured out what that was supposed to be. So I'm glad that the whole artist thing worked out. What advice can you give to people who want to be more artistic or creative? It's hard. Just to pick up a pen and paper and scribble a little bit, doodle. There's a lot you can, even just like doing geometric shapes in the corner of your to-do list can make you feel a little bit more inspired. I don't know. The adult coloring books, I have one. They, I think, inspire creativity. Go to art shows, watch videos of artists online, tutorials and stuff like that. Even if you don't plan on creating a painting, or I think it's inspiring to see how creative people think, and I think that could inspire you even if you're have a 9-to-5 job crunching numbers at a desk or something like that, I think. Or I'm really obsessed with the new whole bullet journaling thing. I think that's a great way to have like structure and something that's beneficial for your life, planning and time management, productivity and all that stuff. But you can work on your hand lettering or use washi tapes and stickers and all that stuff too. I think it's a really great way for regular people to introduce a little creativity. Were you supported to pursue art as a child? I was definitely supported to pursue art. My parents put me in as many art classes at school as I could, that I could take for credits and stuff like that. I think I also took a few after school drawing classes, I remember that. And it was never something that they discouraged me. They bought me tons of art supplies, and I was their little artist at home. And at home it's like a shrine to all of my old work. They have everything that I've ever done on the walls, and it's so horrible to go back. It's also fun to see. I'm just like, what was I thinking? So many different styles and stuff. You'd never imagine the stuff that I have painted and drawn before I came up with this style. Do you make money off your art? Yes, I do. I do, and I'm proud of it. Every year when I do my taxes, I'm both frightened and super proud of myself. It's both like, how did I live off this little money, and also like, all these pennies that I scraped together were made by me, by just drawing my pretty pictures and showing them on the internet, in my web shop, or for commission pieces and stuff like that. So I'm very proud. Clouds keep coming in and out, messing with my beautiful lighting. What do you want to improve on with your art? What I really would like to improve on is staying consistent with sharing my work online. I really would like to have this, like, I don't want to be famous, but it would be nice to be recognized a little bit more often. It would be nice to get recognition and in magazines, more interviews and stuff like that. I just want to share more of my art. I want more people to see it. I want a little nice little community on Instagram who supports me, and my little cheerleaders that are like, "Way to go," all that stuff. YouTube would be fun if I also got a little community here. My aspirations are for a huge following. I don't want to be the next, like, Zoella. Definitely not. That would be frightful. And I also want to continue. I don't want to just, like, stick with my style. It would be nice to branch out, stretch out. Like, now I've always drawn everything with black lines. Starting to inch into, like, using another color for my black lines, which is just seems so weird that it would be difficult, but it is, kind of, because I feel like it all of a sudden, like, doesn't look like the work that I do, but I think that would be healthy for me to do. What feelings do you try to express in your art? My works are very simple and happy and joyful, and they're just simple things that people like, and nothing more than that. I'm not trying to do anything ridiculous or anything like that. They're just simple paintings of things people like, make you happy. What is your favorite thing to draw? Same thing, I like to draw just these simple everyday items that make girls, for the most part, really, really happy, like lipsticks in pretty colors, or a pair of shiny shoes, or a handbag, or a little still life of a bouquet of flowers and a pearl necklace. I think those are the simple things that we have around us, usually, that maybe just, like, don't think about so much. But if you have a little artwork of it, you know, like, you think about the beauty or simplistic beauty behind these everyday items, and I like to focus on that. What's the strangest thing you've drawn? I have received a couple of commissions that are a little bit off. I think some people just they find out that you're an artist, so they assume that you can do every single style and everything in the planet, but that's not always the case. But sometimes I take projects just as a challenge, or because they need the work, etc. One time I was commissioned to do a digital painting of, you know, that old fisherman painting. I don't even know who the artist is, but it's like a portrait of a dude, an old fisherman with a pipe. And someone commissioned me to do, like, a replica of that, but kind of different, with her boyfriend in mind. That was a little bit weird, but it was fun and it came out well, and she was a very good client to work with, so never say never. Have you ever been hung up after starting a commission, and how did you handle it? Hung up, I think they mean by, like, having trouble working on something. I have had trouble working on projects because they haven't felt comfortable, and that's my fault for saying yes to weird projects, but you always gotta try. But for the most part, I try to get a brief that is as descriptive as possible. I make sure that they just say, the client says exactly how they want it. Because in my experience, clients, they always say, it's in your hands, you can do whatever you want, but that's not the case. I have spent many times where I've sketched out my ideas, and then I come with it, and they're like, wait, but we wanted it to be like this, this, and this. And you're like, okay. So now I've learned that I try to press the client to really just tell me exactly what they want, because for the most part, they always have an idea in their head of exactly how they want it. Some clients don't, and then they're very easy to work with, and you send them sketches with your ideas and they actually take them, but that's not always the case. Do you admit paint smells good? I do. I kind of miss painting sometimes. When I was in college, I had this little mini studio at the university, and it was so fun to just like crawl in there, and all my paints were sitting there, and so stinky, everybody else's paints and turpentine, all this crud, and then a ventilation, but maybe it wasn't that good. It was a good time. Paint smells nice. And then what would you tell your younger self? Now the bright sun's coming back out. What would I tell my younger self? I kind of wish that I could have told myself that I would become an artist later on. That would have been kind of nice to know. Might have been nice to have a little heads up that I was going to be an artist, so I could have paid attention to more business details or wrapped my head around how I was going to do it, but I was always caught up in what my style was going to be or what should I paint and all that stuff. So I'm sure you can't really go back, and it's always a good thing to learn from mistakes and all that stuff. I think that's it. That was all 20 questions. I hope that you found this slightly interesting and that you learned more about me and my work, my artwork and what I aspire to and all that stuff. I hope it doesn't sound ridiculous or anything, but thanks so much for watching. See you on the internet, man. Bye! Good.